Hello guys, today we are going to be talking about the modify tool in your silhouette program. It's a great way to draw your own shapes and designs and kind of play around with the outcome of different things. I'm going to just draw a couple of different shapes here that we will use in our tutorial. Let's do a rectangle, a square, and a circle. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to talk about, let's fill these with color really fast, just so we can see exactly what's going on whenever we play around with these different tools. So they're all really different. Okay, so the modify tool has 9 different options. And you're going to open the modify tool by going to the top of your program. There is a square. It has an M with a circle around it. Let's click on that, and then we're just going to take a look at the different options. We have weld, intersect, subtract, crop, subtract all, divide, detach lines. Let's start with welding. Let's overlap these shapes. Just put this one here and this one here, and then we're going to select them all and hit weld. This joins all your shapes together and creates one whole shape. It's great for joining text when you want to cut it all in one piece. You see that we use this a lot whenever we are using a script font, so the letters aren't cutting into the next letter. We just weld them together and it creates one shape. So we're hit Command Z. Okay, and then we're going to grab both of these shapes and hit intersect. Now, whenever you use the intersect option, you'll actually remove the part of the shape that's not overlapping, leaving you with only the overlap part of the shape. So on this piece we have left, just say that we want to have a pie-shaped piece. We can just put this square over the blue part that we want. Just make sure it's all covered. And then we're going to select it all, hit intersect, and it will get rid of that other part. And now we have a nice pie-shaped piece. Okay, we're going to hit Command Z to get back to our 3 shapes. Now we're going to look at the subtract tool. Now the subtract tool is going to change your bottom shape. So if you are wanting to, let's just say we want this to have a circle edge, so it kind of looks like the building blocks that people play with. This pink, we want to make sure that is in the back. That way the blue is on top. We're going to select both and hit subtract, and it cuts a hole in the bottom shape. Now, if you have done this wrong, you wanted to cut out the circle instead of the square, hit Command Z or Control Z. We will move the blue to the back, do the same thing, hit subtract, and you see it made a little Pac-Man out of the shape. Okay, now the crop tool will actually work for 3 or more shapes. So if we just overlap all of these together, we're going to select them all. The crop is going to leave only the parts that are overlapping each other when you have 3 or more shapes. So let's hit Command Z so you can see that again. This part overlaps the pink box. This part of the blue circle overlaps. So when you select all of them and hit crop, it's only leaving the pieces that are overlapping. Now the opposite of that will be the subtract all tool. So if we were to select all these shapes, and we do subtract all, it will actually change the shape and subtract the parts that are covered by other shapes. So it doesn't look like it did anything, but if I were to move this yellow box out of the way, it has taken out where the yellow box was, and the same for the blue circle. It has taken out where the red box was. So that one's subtract all, and we are going to look at divide now and just hit Command Z to get back to where we were. Now the divide tool will actually create individual shapes from the intersection, and this is up to 8 shapes that you can use to divide. So if we just move these around a bit, and we're going to select all of these and hit divide, now you see how many lines we have. So this is going to be everywhere that it intersected, it's going to be separate individual shapes. You can really do a lot with this. Like, this looks like someone's hair, you know, the people that make the little emojis or faces. If you turn this around, and this is hair now, and we'll just go in here and draw, you know, 2 eyes for circles. It's a very simple little emoji thing. It could be handles on glasses over here, or like a little telephone that they're talking on. I mean, they're simple shapes, but you can create some fun designs by playing around with all of these tools that you have available in the Silhouette system. Let's go over here, and this will be a little robot here that we're making. And she's talking on the phone. Of course, this is not a real design, but you just kind of see how it's fun to play around with the shapes. Okay, now we're going to talk about detaching lines. So we have this shape. If we hit detach lines, all it does is make a copy of the shape. So it's a quick way to make another copy that you can then add and change colors or do whatever you need to do with it. So once again, we're on the modify window. We hit detach lines and we just have a copy of the same exact shape that we just had. Okay, the next option is the compound path. So if we select both of these shapes and we click make, then you see that it just merged the selected shapes together into one shape. And the part of the shape that's overlapping the other one is drawn as a whole. So any parts that are touching will be a hole in your compound path. Now, if you have a design that has a hole such as this and you want to get rid of the hole, you can release the compound path and it makes it all one area. And once again, once you click it, make, you have a hole, release, it's all one shape. When you release this, I know this is not in the modify options, but if you wanted to put all this together as one piece, right click and hit weld, and now you have one piece. Okay guys, I hope this answered any questions you had about the modify options that are in Silhouette Studio. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And thank you for watching.